Hey yo together and very welcome to Let's Play XCOM 2 War of the Chosen, the expansion with mods, lots of mods. I know I should maybe just let's play it without any mods, but sadly when I purchased the game I played it, so it's not really super fresh and new. Sure, I could try a legendary walkthrough, but I decided to do it that way. More fun for all of us, and this time, as promised, with a promise that I will play through this setting. So in the link in the description of the video you can see all of the links. I think I will have the link with the mods there, so you can just download them and play them yourself if you want to, if you have the game. There will be the link to the Excel sheet. There you can submit a character, a rough layout, which I can adapt and then put into this game so that I have enough soldiers to play through. Currently only 2 people have signed up, which is a little bit sad, but I hope that with the continuing of the campaign more and more people come. And if it's fun, if you like it, and if you stick to it, if you get through the end, eventually we will. I promise, eventually we will. Maybe I will start a second run with legendary playthrough then, and some more mods, we don't know. Yes, so what else? I will play on Commander Iron Man, but not really Iron Man. So with all of those mods... Oh no. Yeah, with all of those mods installed, there is a problem. Sometimes the game can crash. Okay, and if that's happening, then if you have the Iron Man, sometimes the file can get corrupted, which is not good at all. So I will just say, so it's an Honored Man playthrough. I won't cheat, I won't load and go back if something goes wrong. I promise you that. Okay, anything else? No, I think that's it. We have DLCs, we have the War of the Chosen, we have the Alien Hunter, and we have the Shen's Last Gift, so Sparks will be part of it. I haven't used them at all, I haven't seen much of it. I also haven't seen much of the mods I use now. So it will basically for me be a pretty fresh game, very challenging, and I would say we just start now. So we go on Commander for me, Legend is a little bit too much. So we start with Commander for now. If I get through it, we will do Legend eventually, I guess. Show subtitles. I don't want to have any of those advanced things. I don't think we need them. They can be very interesting, like Grim Horizon can be very strong. Time Turner is just making it easier. Double the length of the Avatar Project, also making it easier. This could be interesting, but makes the game significantly harder, I think. And Better Strike is like nothing works anymore. You can't have those ambushes. I don't know if the HP of your own units are increased as well. That would be interesting, but it just for me it's somewhat ruining the specifics and the balancing of the game, but can be very interesting. But we play without any advanced options. So next, Commander. Okay, next I will play Iron Man, as I said. Maybe I should switch the game now. Iron Man. I will enable the Lost and Abandoned. I will have the Alien Hunter DLC and the Shen's Last Gift DLC. This just integrates those two missions into the game itself without having those missions. So you get the content basically, but not the missions. That's what I wanted to say. Okay. And then we start, and then I can search what I lost. Okay.
Accessing the feed now. We're in. But I don't know for how long. You seeing this? Way too much security, even for Advent.
That's no ordinary gene therapy clinic. They were telling the truth.
Or they're leading us into a trap. A really obvious trap.
We'd need an army to march in there right now.
I've got a better idea. Outrider, this is Central. Go.
Placed upon us, mistakes are bound to happen.
It wasn't our fault. Please!
There's no need for any of this. I will do what you ask of me. I just need additional time. Did you say something? You're one of those.
You must understand. I had no choice. Outrider, report.
So, you do exist. Outrider to Avenger, I have visual confirmation.
Are you sure?
Reapers are always sure.
I'll take your word for it. Cover your tracks and get the hell out of there. They can't know we were here. Yet.
Understood. Now the real war begins.
Excitement continues to build as city centers across the globe prepare for the 20th anniversary of Unification Day.
Thousands line up at the site of the Great Accord, celebrating the formation of the Advent Coalition.
Keeping with their promise to humanity, 12 new gene therapy clinics will be opening in select cities by the end of the new year.
Despite the attempted attack by fringe elements, operations at the new facility in Paris thankfully remain unaffected.
In response to the unprovoked intrusion on the eve of our most beloved celebration, the speaker reaches out to us.
A small number of dissidents again repeat the mistakes of the old world.
Striking as we celebrate the benevolent savior who time and again offers only friendship and compassion.
Yet these trivial actions could never break the bond between humanity and the Elders.
Peacekeeping forces have already made several preemptive arrests of known collaborators. Advent again assures all citizens that today's celebrations will continue as planned.
Perfect.
Reminds you to report all suspicious activity to your nearest peacekeeper. Only together can we build a bed tomorrow.
Approaching position. You were right. They've definitely got their hands full today.
Stay focused. Prep gate crasher. 60 seconds.
Your turn. know that we're serious. That we're ready to infiltrate the city centers and strike at their heart. To that effect, we're moving in to take out a high-profile target that will get plenty of people's attention, especially Advent. Move to lock down the area and eliminate any security forces nearby.
Okay, so let me see if we are... Yeah, looking good. We are recording. Okay.
Menace 1-5, we have a fix on the target. Move to place the X-4 charges at the designated position.
Befinden uns in verborgener Position.
Okay. Man, I love me some XCOM. This will be very, very difficult. Okay, so... I don't know. Let's see what we do here. So, I don't know how much I should explain of this game. So basically what happens is that we have... 20 years ago there was an alien invasion where we fought. As XCOM against the aliens, but we lost. And now Advent basically is something the aliens did to get the humans on their side, a nice face if you want so, curing cancer, stuff like that. But we believe we know it better. We believe that that Advent is bad for us and it's not nice to humans, so we want still to reclaim Earth, and here we are with guerrilla tactics and so on. So now we need to neutralize all enemy targets and plant X4 charges on this monument, which looks very weird in my opinion. And currently we are concealed, meaning that we can't be seen unless we get flanked or too near those turrets, those sensor towers, or Advent troops or civilians. So we need to be extra careful. Yeah, so let's just use our concealment to have a peek.
Confirmed.
Get a glimpse on the map where we are currently at. So what I like to do is to spread out my troops a little bit here. The characters I will get through after the mission. And I will also try to get your character the weapons and the class you featured in the Excel table or in the bin file. If you have the game and create your soldier, you can send me the bin file on my email address I posted in the comment section, in the description section. And then I will give you, so if you say you want to be skirmisher, you will be skirmisher. That's it. Okay, so where do we go now? Cover is always good. Full cover is better. Like here we would have full cover, but I hate cars, because cars, they... sometimes stuff happens which I don't like, so I try to avoid cars whenever possible. So I don't see any Advent. There are some civilians that are not doing much to us, so I go here. That's not perfect, but should be kinda safe. For now, okay. I will stick with the car, at least with one soldier here. Okay, there's Advent. A trooper, a gunslinger, and what's the last thing? A medi-drone. Okay. So those are modded units. The trooper is not modded, but the medi-drone and the gunslinger definitely are. So, and with myself... yeah, okay, let's go to the car. I know, I just said I want to avoid them, but for now it should be fine. I hope they don't see us, which they shouldn't currently. I need to know where else people are. I would love to go on top of this building, but as you can see, this tower is blocking vision. Our path, I mean. So, maybe I can go around? Let's see. No, not really. I mean, there would be a pathway up. Could work, but also could get really bad for us. Yeah, but maybe, I don't know if I should go in or not. I like high ground. High ground can be very dangerous, but also can be very nice. So at least two guys should be on top. So let's see. Don't misclick this.
Heading to that location.
Yeah, that's our goal.
Menace 1-5, you're near the target position.
Okay. So why? What's there? That's not good. Okay, so I just go there now. I need to scout. Before I do any strange movement, I definitely need to scout. So here I have high cover, should be fine. Let's have a peek inside, maybe? I definitely will so fail. Okay. Maybe go there for now. And then there. I want on top of this building. I want to go on top of this building. That's very important. So, overwatch. Don't shoot. Just overwatching. Be safe. Just in case something happens. There are definitely more guys than just those three here. And I don't really know what the Medidrone and the Gunslinger does. I can imagine the Medidrone is healing stuff, so that's obvious, but I need to be careful here. So where's is this? No, not shotgun. I want Papa Roach first. Okay, so I will go maybe I shouldn't go up right there right now. Maybe I should, I don't know. Can I get on top? Yes, I can go the whole mile, but I think I don't know if no, there are no civilians, I guess. I hope so. I don't see them. Sometimes the game is a little bit buggy. If there are civilians on top here, then I might be in a lot of trouble. There are civilians, so they spot you and they report you. That's the bad thing. Civilians are not nice to you. If I go there, I have the high cover. I don't know how good this would be for shooting stuff, but I think I just go there. And he goes maybe there.
Go, go, go.
And I could go here, but I think I go there first. I don't know if there's anything here, which there isn't. So difficult. I would love to be to take cover here, but apparently I cannot. This is dangerous. If those move like up here, they spot me, because then they see me, and this just two tiles away. That's too risky. So maybe just go here. It's far from optimal, but I guess that's the way to go. I also want to see what else we got here for opponents, or where at least they are. This turret is problematic, to say the least, for me. So here I would have really nice aim, which I could take. I now could get here, which I will do. I hope there is no... Oh! Okay.
The advent officers seem more capable than the grunts.
Okay.
We're not sure whether
I need to retreat here.
Or stricter mind
control. I don't want to activate this port as well. So I just go. Okay, I go back. Let's say for. I can't move away here. If they come up, I have a lot of problems. So. He definitely goes there.
Okay, je bouge.
Overwatch. Can I go somewhere else which would be nice? Nope. I could go here. That's not too bad. Okay. I take that spot. Half cover is not the best. Full cover would be better, but I like the hate advantage for shooting people. I hope they don't go up here, but it looks like they don't. I need to retreat with I think that's Aatrox up there. Oh, that's... Oh, they are so near. Okay, no misclicks here, please. So, let's see. Okay, I need to... that's not working. I don't want to be spotted, so I need... he's so far away. That's not good. I don't want to face this troop alone here, but maybe I just can... Maybe I can just go here, here. He's still not able to move without being seen below our cover, so I just stick with it. Ah, okay. So they're moving away now, that's good. I need to collect my units there and see. So now he's free to move, which I definitely will do. Now this roof would be way nicer to be on, but I don't know if I could make it. As you can see, I'm taking myself a lot of time. I don't want to make any mistakes here. Because with mistakes, bad stuff happens all the time. I could go up there, but I don't know if there are enemies here. It's unlikely, but possible. And then I would be flanked, cover blown, most of my units can't move anymore. That would be very bad for us. He has such a nice aim. And of course, this is just chance. Oh, he has also height advantage. Okay, I just... no, let's... okay, let's just have him there. I want to kill this troop first because of the midi drone, which I think will heal units. Okay, so Aatrox, Mad-Eye, he will go first of all there. Have a look where they are. Okay. I like having the... Yeah, see? If I would have gone there, they definitely would have seen me. So, that's not nice. So he doesn't see anything now. I can go there.
Headed there now.
I can go... there. I could move down here. For some flanking shots, okay. Potentially. I'm still waiting for the perfect moment to strike. Because this game, it doesn't if you make a mistake, it punishes you for making them. Okay, so I would love to throw a grenade. But I think if I do this... in the worst case, nothing dies. That would be not good. But I think eventually I have to activate them. What were my chances? I could go here or here. Depending on where... No, that's not good. They will most likely take cover here, so I can't flank them. I need to wait another turn, I guess. Yes. I think I need to wait another turn here. I could go here. Or... I go up there.
Okay.
I hope they don't move further away, but maybe if they come back, that would be perfect. But I don't know.
Affirmative, covering now.
So what are they doing? Okay, this could work out quite nicely for me. I also wonder, maybe I shouldn't throw a grenade. You know, maybe I should take this shot. It has a good crit chance, as you can see. It has nice damage. It's almost guaranteed to hit, which is really nice. How good can this guy? Yeah, 92%. It's a really good shot on the Advent Trooper. I don't know if I should try to kill the Medidrone, but I don't have any crit chance there, so. Eh. The Trooper it is, I guess. Okay, let's hope. Oh, what a perfect start for our XCOM career. Okay, no, that's not gonna happen. 92% missed. And that's XCOM. You know, that's how XCOM works. So I go here now, because that was my backup plan. To flank this guy, hopefully kill him now. 89. Crit 40, still living. XCOM still beating me up really badly. I could go in and throw a grenade, but you normally don't want to waste a grenade on one guy. I could go here, flank him and potentially kill him. Okay? And then I could throw a grenade here to kill this guy. I mean, I have to. Or I have double full cover. Okay, you know what? I need to do something here. If I go here and flank by this guy, I can kill for sure. Then there's only the Medidrone left, which is all I can do now. 72. Missed again. Okay, that's XCOM. Okay, now I can't go there because... Where else do I go now? Is there full cover on the bottom? But you see the unluck I got so far. 90% miss, 70% miss, and that's XCOM. And it's super annoying already. Could be that I lose the first mission here. Okay, I just throw a grenade here and that's it, because I can't do anything else. I would have needed to move Jules first. But I didn't do it. So I am super flanked. Damage and disoriented, which is not nice. I hope he doesn't hit. But they hit with 50%, you know? They have the coin flip. They have the coin flip and they hit. And I have lots of trouble here. And that's what I hate about XCOM. But that's how the game works. So I don't know if I made a huge mistake. I mean, you think... If you have a 90% hit chance, that you hit, you know. But apparently, that's not how it works. So the trooper needs to die right now. What is going on? 84 missed again. I don't know. And he wasn't disoriented, you know. Do I really have to? I can't throw grenades. I think Jules will die now. Okay, so what I can do is I can go here.
Okay, been unterwegs.
Throw a grenade to potentially blow away some cover. And of course he survives. I can rotate maybe, I don't know where. Where should I rotate to? Maybe down there.
On your order.
I already hate XCOM again. All those chances.
Yeah, I didn't get it.
How unlucky am I? Seriously. He's disoriented. He won't have a great shot, but he needs to hit. And now there's the crit. Uh-huh. Okay, I see. So the drone goes in. If it attacks again and hits, one damage, disoriented. It's not good, but I can't do much else here. Wait, is he going to burn? No. Can I go up again? Yes.
Schon unterwegs.
I just hope that the ground won't collapse. That would be bad. Okay, finally the hits come through. But I was never so unlucky, let me tell you. I never was so super unlucky. And the problem is, this is just the first one. The first mission, the first pod I activated, there are more to come. I can't heal my units, which is bad.
Ich gehe schon. Heading out.
Back online.
Waffe geladen.
Oh man. I already hate XCOM now. So he is not any longer disoriented, which is nice, but I need to get down. That's over. Very important. Okay. I need to get away from this roof, because if it might collapse, I will take fall damage and then I die. And I definitely don't want to die here. Already three soldiers wounded in the first mission. And this is on commander difficulty. This is not legendary. You can have flawless missions, but if everything goes so bad, I don't know what else I should do. So I know there was a pot. I hope I don't activate them by going here. Okay, that's nice. That's really nice.
Wechsle Position. Tout de suite.
I don't know about this. I don't know where they are. That's the big problem I have. And this is good cover, which I shouldn't leave.
Bitte Feuerschutz.
Shh, I think I heard something.
There they are. Okay, they are still there. I don't know if they move. That's the next thing. If they move, then I might have some possibilities.
Was ist da drüben?
If they don't move, then that's bad. I don't want to risk it. So I'm super cautious now. I hope they move and I hope they come close to us. There they are. Oh, please hit, please, please. Oh man. Hopefully they come closer so I can hit them. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on! Nice! Oh, finally the hits come through. I need those damn promotions. If I go here, they can't see me. No matter what they do. So this would be safe. I need full cover. I definitely need full cover. He has full cover, yeah, that's the problem. So the question is, do I just retreat now? There are 2 versus 4. If I retreat, maybe I get a good shot off. Okay, the problem is most of my guys are wounded already, which is really bad. If I go here, he needs to get there to shoot those, because that's a really good spot to hide. The thing is, I only can hide 2 people here. And then that's it. I can't hide people there, only here. Maybe I can go there as well. Can I? Yes. What's with Papa Jules? Maybe I put him here and hunker down and that's it. It's the best I can do, I think. Okay, so you go there. You go there. You go there. Okay.
Bitte Feuerschutz.
Je suis parti.
I could blow up some. Yeah, that's not bad. How many grenades do I have left? But it would be guaranteed damage I can pull out now in this turn. Should I do it? Shouldn't I? I can't blow up stuff anywhere else because this is massive. I can't kill that, so I go for it now. 3 damage, that's fine. You hunker down. Get more increase, more dodge. And then pray. Oh, he's burning! Oh, that's perfect! Okay, he goes on Overwatch, that's nice. And he probably will go on Overwatch as well. Okay. That's perfect because I can work with that. I can sneak around here. If I go here, they shouldn't be able to get their Overwatch off. Here they can't see me. And I'm just moving into this tile and then I am there. Could work, potentially. Maybe not. As long as they are on Overwatch, I can't really do much. But as long as I'm in full cover, I'm fine. The question is... Ah, you can go further. I still have one grenade left, which I probably will use next turn. The difficulty is, if I go here, this guy in the next round can flank me. So I need to back him up by moving here and there with Overwatch. If it doesn't work, he will be flanked and probably die. That's bad. That's really bad. I think here I could still get flanked. So, okay. Okay, okay, okay. I can go there, but I can't get any good shots off because... Wait. Wait. No. The advent, this guy is burning. No, wait. No. He's burning, I guess. He should be burning. Okay, this is what he can. I thought he was burning. Huh! He didn't hunker down. He needs to burn. Why isn't he burning? That's strange. I think the game is not on my side. But I think that's the best shot I get. Hunker down here again. Move there with Mad-Eye. Shoot this guy. Pray to the RNGesus that he hits and crits and this guy dies. And back him up. Nah, he can't get in cover there and only here. And there I can shoot him. With there and there. That's the best shot I have. Should I do it? Or should I go in here and throw a grenade, remove Overwatch? But then I still... No, I only have this grenade. But you know what? He goes down. Oh, I can go there! No, wait. Target preview. Maybe he will shoot there. Yes, he should shoot there. Because he sees that movement. He can't see that movement, but he definitely can see that movement, I think. Okay, so... Okay, I have to do something here, you know? So... That's my plan. I hope it works. No! Oh, why? Okay. I thought it would work, but this didn't trigger. Come on, get him, please! Ah, nice. Overwatch. Hunker down, because he's really in pain. Okay, come on. Hit! Ah! Hit, please! Ah, that's not enough. So he got through. Yeah, he's flanked, he will die. Oh, I'm so lucky! Okay. Now he dies. Oh, I'm so lucky. I hope that's the only part, because if there's even more, I am... What are you doing? Okay, so all I can do now is Okay, you know what? I take some bad shots here. Just in case. Maybe I hit. You never. Oh, what's going on? Oh, I thought I triggered another pot. Okay. Glad that wasn't the case. I go there because it doesn't matter where I go. I just take the bad shots I have. Maybe I hit, maybe I don't. Doesn't matter, so. Just take your chances. 41, probably not, but. Okay.
Hostile terminated.
Okay, that was everything. I think on Legendary you have a third group of hostiles which do bad stuff to you. So let's see what we get here, loot-wise. This loot will expire if you don't grab it. Repeater. Nah, that's okay. Would have loved some Illyrium core, but it's nice. So X4 and then we're out! 92, 80, 88, 72. I missed so many good shots. That was the first mission, and that's not on Legendary, you know. That's why I play Commander. Normally, I think you have 9 enemies on the first mission. Which is doable, even flawless, instead of excellent, without having anyone wounded, but... Hey, so it's RNGesus, and this time he wasn't on my side. So, let's get some photos here, okay? Wait. No, let's wait, because... this will all change. We do it next time. Next mission we will do the photos, because...
If 20 years of peace and prosperity will not be undone by the reckless actions of a few misguided dissidents today. We stand with the elders, trust in their wisdom, and we shall overcome this crisis.
What I wanted to say, yes, if they get now the promotions, but not the class they are wanted to be assigned, then that just is not right. So I need to redo this, and then we will do the photo. So only squaddies get their photo, not rookies. That's a rule I just do now. That was so bad. 9 days, 16 days. He is gravely wounded, yeah, lightly wounded. So let's see what we get here.
The
perfect.
Ranger serves as our primary reconnaissance unit.
Nice match.
Capable of moving independently in concealment while engaging enemies at close range.
That's perfect, because he always was our ranger in the previous one, so I like that. Okay. So he gets a sword, a slash attack. Which is really strong. Later on, if he gets Blade Master, it will be even more strong. Yep, nice. Welcome there. So,
just like it sounds,
that's the thing.
Sharpshooters
he should be a heavy.
With pinpoint accuracy from extreme range. They're also trained in pistol marksmanship for the occasional close encounter.
So, that's not right. He should be... So he gets the... I don't know why he gets... Oh, he gets the ability to fire a pistol. Yeah, okay. I see. Squad side. So, that's wrong, apparently.
Experts, the Grenadiers provide heavy ordnance delivery whenever and wherever we need it.
Sometimes I'm a sniper, but this time I don't want to be a sniper. I want to be something else. So, I will switch that. And this should be then our...
Operating some of our most advanced
specialist,
equipment.
Yeah.
Specialists deploy robotic drones on the battlefield that can be outfitted for combat or field medic duty.
Okay, looking good so far. I think I need to switch the webcam somewhere else because you don't see the guy talking. I just don't know where else I should put it. Or if I should... No, you need the webcam. You need to see my reactions. That's important. But yeah, maybe I put it there, but there are the objectives of the mission, so if I put it left down there, probably, but I don't know, we will see. Because there you see the name and everything, ugh. So webcam is difficult, maybe I just let it be there. I don't know. So we get the repeater. I have a mod that just adds 1 plus 1 to crit damage. Normally the repeater does plus 5% chance to instant kill, but I like this this cranked up crit damage more because it enforces you or encourages you to flank opponents more often to benefit. So I like that change. Okay, so I will do the armory
Commander
right now,
to the research labs.
And then I will get through those soldiers. I think some don't even have a real how it's called. So he's
the crew to stay away from the Advent meat rations. We still don't know what they're putting in that stuff.
Yeah, so he doesn't have any biography. That's sad. But that's our LeJules Paparoach, our specialist. He will be, if he survives, one of our most important guys out there, because specialists are super important. They are so diverse, so versatile, I think it's called. They are super important. So I like him. LeJules, welcome to our team. Who else do we have? Yes. This needs to be Aatrox, so let's see, customize, load from character pool. Oh no, wait, that's wrong. I need to change the name first. Okay. I think that's how it was called. Yep, there he is. I need to check just the... That's a little bit of fishy to do so. Yeah, his weapon and stuff thingy. So his weapon is alien and his armor is tundra. Okay. So weapon body is tundra, that fits. I don't know why it doesn't load the weapon, but we have our pinky. I think that's the one, and it was alien, I think. So that's our Aatrox here, not looking too nice. Biography also none, but I know him out of my university where I'm studying, so he's our heavy hitter here. Welcome to the team. I like him, our little pinky. So who else we got? Cube Crusher, I think, also didn't submit a biography there. Nope, but he's our ranger, our bad guy, our badass, our super nice guy. I like his look with the glasses. He will be our flanking master or our blade master. Depending on which route he got, we will see. And then I need to get a sharpshooter there. Who else do we have here as a sharpshooter? Yes, that's the thing. We have here our Tyra Avain. But what's the... okay, that's what I do. So let me see how I do this. Because we want a sharpshooter, and we get a sharpshooter. How is she called? Tyra Avain. I hope I can put this correct here. First name. I hope that's correct. There she is. So the weapon is not correct. The weapon needs to be red. I think it was. And the weapon pattern, I think it was alien. Or was it Blots? I think it was Blots, but I'm not quite sure. Okay, so welcome, you will be our sharpshooter. And what do we have here? Tyra, I hope that's spelled out correctly. Avain, codename, nickname Arrow, our sharpshooter. And what does she have for character info? Country of origin, Japan. Date of birth, October 21, 1993. After Advent invaded her hometown, Tara was able to survive hiding in a hidden safe spot for several days. Eventually, Exxon was sent on a raid mission near her hideout. She managed to help them locating several crates, but was wounded while helping XCOM soldiers in the battle against Advent troopers. After that, she joined XCOM to reclaim her hometown and taste freedom again. So, I like her. She's looking quite nice. And not very lucky here with her scars and stitches, but... oh yeah, she doesn't look lucky at all. Or happy. Okay, I like it. Nice, very nice character. And then what we need to do, last thing, is get this one to be mine. So let's see. And then we continue playing. There we go. Weapon is the last thing I need to do. Color, of course, some nice looking blue. I don't know which blue it was. Probably that one. Yeah. I think that's how it is. So I will be a rookie for now. I will see what I get later on. Okay, let's continue.
Impressive, isn't it? Capable of generating immense power. Yet completely harmless to human life. If only the same could be said for the rest of the aliens' technology. Commander. Dr. Richard Tigan, Chief Science Officer. I am responsible for the entirety of our research here, as well as the procedure you so recently underwent. Welcome to my lab, such as it is. I'm not sure what Central may have told you, but we found something while removing you from the alien stasis suit. A device implanted directly in your occipital lobe. Had I access to the equipment available to me during my tenure at Advent, I would already know the precise nature of its function. However, given time and your approval, of course, Commander, I assure you, I will find out. Which brings to light an additional point. Though aspects of this facility are indeed impressive, I am but one man. Were you to direct additional support personnel and resources to me, I could substantially improve the speed of all our research. A farewell, Commander.
Yes, he's our lead scientist, and if you haven't figured out by now, in the first video clip, the Reaper finding the stasis suit, me, the commander, were trapped in there, taken by the aliens after failing the first attempt of defending the first invasion. So yeah, and now we are back, and he removed this chip out of our brain. Nice. So let's see what we get here. I think modular weapons will be nice, so we can just improve our weapons. So that's what we do here.
I do find that
okay, reworked your repulsors with some of the parts I salvaged from their old engine. Should fix that stabilization problem you had. Come on, Rover. It'll work. Commander! Getting our tech to talk to theirs is harder than you'd think. Lily Shen, Chief Engineer, at your service. You were probably expecting to see my father. In all that's happened, I'm guessing Central didn't tell you yet. He's gone. Dad gave everything he had to get us this far. This entire ship is his life's work. I know he would have loved to show you around the place himself. He used to talk about you a lot. You can be sure I'm ready to finish what he started. Might not look it, but from here, I can fabricate pretty much anything you come up with. And with a little more help, well, you'd be amazed with what I can do. It was an honor to finally meet you, Commander.
So, that's our engineering, where we can build items, build facilities, and we will build facilities.
There's room for us to expand our facilities on board the Avenger, Commander, but we'll need more engineers to clear out space for construction first.
Yep, so this is how our ship looks like, and we can build stuff there, which we will do. I think I will go with the Guerrilla Tactics School first, which should be fine. It's not perfect, but it's all I can do now. The laboratory isn't that great in the beginning. The training center can be nice, but I think I will push this back further. Because I'm playing the Lost and Abandoned mission, I can't produce the resistance ring yet, so this will take time. I would love to have it, but it's just not possible right now, so we go with the Guru attack.
Go start work on the new facility right away, Commander. I'll send word when it's up and running.
And then we go finally to the Geoscape.
Commander.
Geospace, whatever.
Good to see
Geoscope.
You on your feet again. Welcome to the bridge, the nerve center of our operation. The aliens have our entire world in their grip. Advent controls everything. Government, communications, industry, not to mention the military. And it's on us to take it all back. Resources and time are tight, Commander. It'll be up to you to decide how to best use both. The ship is yours.
Well, thank you.
Commander, we're attempting contact with a local resistance faction known as the Reapers.
Mm-hmm.
These people like to keep a very low profile, so it may take some time before we hear back. While we're waiting, it might be worthwhile to scan the area for additional supplies and resources.
Mm-hmm.
You never know what we may find out there.
Commander, one of our resistance contacts just tipped us off to a site that may be worth investigating.
New course.
Okay, so we investigate this. Soldiers.
Commander, the Avengers' remote scanning capabilities will help us search the area for clues or other resources. It's going to take some time, though. We've got a lot of ground to cover.
Yeah, I would love to start with an engineer, but
I'm sure you will find the results
not happening here.
As I do, Commander.
So we got the modular weapons finished. I don't know if I should read over all of those. I think I just skip that, as it will draw the missions and the let's play way too far. But if you are interested, you can read it itself. You can read it yourself. It is sometimes very interesting, but most of them I have read already myself, so I don't want to repeat it, and you can do it yourself. So we get magnetic weapons and weapon upgrades are available. Genau. Oops. Weapon upgrades, like the repeater. We can now attach repeater and stuff to our weapons. So magnetic weapons will take 28 days. I think I will skip this for now and go with the alien biotech first.
Word as soon as we have something of note. Working at the Advent Clinic.
No, I always do this when they talk. I skip it. I hate it. Should take myself more time. So who we got? Squatty Sally Armstrong. Okay. That's a computer generated soldier. So I don't go over those. And more rookies. Okay, we get soldiers to spare. No engineer, no scientist, no nothing, just soldiers here.
Commander, as the resistance continues to grow, we'll have a better chance of finding
There's our engineer.
Strike back at Advent.
Item.
As it is, we've already identified a potential target to disrupt the aliens' operations in this region.
Witchclaw.
Our window of opportunity is limited, so we'll have to move fast.
Okay, so we need to recover an item from the Resistance Haven. Difficulty is easy, and we get an engineer.
Setting
so we will do this, and I will stop recording here. The loadout will be next mission, next let's play, next video, so I will skip here for now, and then we see us in the next episode. So if you want to join, feel free to do so down in the description. Either send me the bin file of your character in the email, or go over to the Excel sheet, the Google Docs, and put in everything yourself with help of the info video I should also link down there. With that said, thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. As always, I wish you a very nice day and goodbye. Heyo there, thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions, put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care. Bye bye. We'll be right back.